philosophers were in my life since I was like 19 or 20, because I studied political science, and when I read Jean-Jacques Rousseau or Montesquieu, it was fascinating, and I really thought that this was like the purity of the birth of the ideas that led to democracies. But then after that, you learn about the real politics and what the philosopher write about and what the reality is like. There's a big gap. So I that was my main drive behind the character of Souverain, who's from Haiti. He's a political science student. He's young. He has like very naive idea about politics, and for him, democracy comes from these books that he's read, and he's very enthusiastic about it. So I had read these books. Actually, the book of Jean-Jacques Rousseau that we see in the film is the book I bought.
Souverain, c'est ça, hein?
Oui. Oui.
Pourquoi tu veux suivre un stage ici, à Rapide, loin de la capitale, loin de tout?
Eh bien, j'ai envoyé ma lettre à son député, mais vous êtes le seul qui m'a répondu.
T'arrives tout exactement?
Pour aux presses, exactement.
OK.
Pour le stage, je suis en mission, pour apprendre.
Because I wanted to make a film about a very ordinary politician with no power. I mean, it's not about a minister, it's not about the prime minister, it's not about a big president, it's just an ordinary politician in a very, like, far away region of Quebec. So I had to go research and follow a real politician to see what he does, you know, what his job is. And it's very boring. He has to attend all these kinds of, like, parties, he has to be, you know, to close to his voters, but nothing really happens. And so I did some research, and I found out that working as a politician is not a glamorous job. It can be very hard and very boring and very long hours, especially in a country like Canada, where geography is so huge that to cover all your field, you have to take the car and you have to drive kilometers and kilometers.
Quand je suis au Parlement, les lundis, vendredis, je consacre ça au bureau. Lis mes documents, raconte le monde du comté.
Je suis une fille du Nord, née une nuit d'aurore.
Mardi, mercredi, jeudi, je fais du terrain.
Tu vas voir, pas ça qui manque par ici, du terrain.
Vous voulez quoi aujourd'hui?
Commencez, là. Appuyez-nous donc.
Y a pas de secret, hein, souverain. Faut rester proche du monde.
I think there's many filmmakers out there who are very good, are not only concerned about, like, emotions and love and they don't have any real political or social canvas in their film. I have in pretty much all my film. Even my film Señor Lazar was a film that had like a social context that was very strong, and it was talking about immigration and the context in the school. But I think my role is to ground my stories into a particular social context, but I don't think the films can change anything. Maybe I did 20 years ago, but I don't think a film can change really anything now. I think it can open some eyes for the audience, and maybe that combined with literature, with songs, with meeting, with travel, that can change individuals, but not just one film. I don't think it can. I think it has to participate with other inputs, and I don't think I haven't seen any films that really changed the way politics is been done.
Ben raconte, t'es parti à cause du terrorisme en Algérie?
On peut dire ça.
It's happening right now in Canada. I mean, there's a lot of people who want Canada to pull out of the war against the Islamic State. Some of other people want to continue, especially that there's been like 6 Canadians that died in a terrorist attack in West Africa. But who do we fight? A lot of people don't want Syrian refugees because they're afraid that there are terrorists amongst them, not understanding that these refugees actually are fleeing those same terrorists and the same and that war in Syria. So I think the presence of refugees, of immigrants, forces us to rethink the way we see what's happening outside the country, because unlike in the film, it does affect us. What I wanted to show in the film is that people think that a war very far away from us don't concern us. They rather talk about their own job and their own roads and but that we are in a world now that everything is linked.
Je demande un mandat clair au Parlement pour envoyer l'armée.
Tu vas voter pour? Quoi?
Je vais m'abstenir.
T'abstenir?
Je vais commencer par régler les problèmes dans le comté. Je sauverai la planète après.
Vous pouvez consulter les électeurs. Vous êtes indépendant.
Pas sûr que j'ai le temps pour ça, moi. Quelqu'un qui veut une bière?
It's all of a sudden it's changing back. We've had 10 years of conservative government that have been very close to immigrants. Even they set up like new visas for Mexican immigrants. And that was a new thing. That was quite of a scandal, I think. But Trudeau, the new government, is changing that. But it's really some sort of pendulum, I think. And unless we get our own population to open up, I think there will always be resistance to immigration because of fear. And a lot of people are very good at fomenting fear of the other, of the people that we don't know. And I realize in my own personal life that the people around me, the people who are fearful of immigrants are the people who are never traveling, never get outside the country.
Hey Lou, c'est ce qui serait cool, et qui serait temps, c'est que pour une couple de jours, toi et moi on sac notre camp.
He's a friend, so he can come up. He can come in the process way before we shoot. He reads the script, we discuss. I send him films, which I like the music. And this time around, he said, "I think we need to build a theme song that will come back and get into people's head." And I like that idea. And then he composed something like a few months before that I really loved. And so I had a sample of that in my iPod. So on the set, sometimes I could pace the scene with that particular rhythm, which is like a kind of a band playing out. And because the story is about someone who tries to get somewhere and is always stopped on the road, I wanted to avoid the feeling for the audience that the film was always stopped. I needed the music to push the film forward like a train, like a locomotive. And the music does that. It tells the audience that the movie is always moving forward. And when I shot the scenes in Haiti, I stumbled onto this like marching band by chance, and I loved their costumes, and I knew my theme song was perfect for a marching band, so I asked Martin to send me the partitions, the music sheets, and we gave them the sheets, and they learned it, into an open-air small park. And then we shot them the day after coming to the lens, and I thought it was nice because for me it felt like it was like the Greek chorus at the end, you know, and it was kind of them telling us the story. The Bleeder is very different from my other film. I was talking earlier about social and political canvas in my film. This film has none. It's just a fun film about a dude from New Jersey in 75 who fought Muhammad Ali, who was the greatest boxer of all time. And he lost in 15 rounds, but he stayed up for 15 rounds, and his fight inspired Sylvester Stallone to write Rocky. So when Rocky came out, this guy started to think he was the real Rocky, and got to his head, and his life kind of spiraled down. And I was working with some great actors, Liev Schreiber, Elizabeth Moss, Naomi Watts. I had a great time, although we didn't have enough money to do the film. It's a period film. And I'm cutting the film right now, so it should be ready next fall.
Je vais vous dire, moi, ce qui va changer si on part en guerre.
Des gens!
Qui c'est qui est pour la guerre ici?
T'es rentré en politique pour changer les affaires?
Mais tu peux pas.
Même avec la plus grande volonté du monde, t'as pas de pouvoir.
Ce serait le fun que nos sacrifices en valent la peine.
Votez pour Canada for Freedom.
Le monde ici, ils veulent des jobs.
Avez-vous fini de nous prendre pour des melons?
Moi, je dis fuck off!
Tu n'as pas d'opinion.
Ton vote est pas à vendre.
Pour ou contre?
Me semble que c'est simple.
Puis toi, Guibard, c'est quoi ton opinion?
Mon petit gang de malades!